We're tracking about 27,000 things in space.
And Privateer's mission is really a consortium to share information with others to a great extent, not just say, oh, we're just going to collect it and keep it private.
These satellites in particular that we worry about the most are their low Earth orbit satellites, tracking and monitoring and ultimately predicting where these things go so that we don't end up creating more debris that makes it impossible for us to use space in the future. If you look at the crew on the International Space Station, right, they have a Whipple shield. It's kind of like Kevlar and aluminum. And that Whipple shield has kind of a catastrophic impact that anything above about 1 centimeter is a mortal hit. We're tracking all of these debris that are larger than 10 centimeters. That can include micrometeorites or small meteors or pieces of other missions, screws, nuts, bolts, things that were glued on to other things.
That, you know, we've done enough as humans to mess up the Earth and mess up the oceans, and we're doing the same thing in space.
It is comedy, but it's also tragedy. For years, we'd kind of joked about maybe someday we'd be the first space garbage men. We'd ride on the back of the trash truck, and we'd take disabled satellites and toss them in the compactor. From a climate standpoint, the best sensors we have are in space. All of these things that we've done to mess up our own environment on Earth, the only way we'll solve it is at a macro level, and that's spend sensors on space, looking at Earth, helping us unwind and undo the damage one step at a time, the same way that we did it. We won't be able to solve it overnight, but we wouldn't be able to solve it at all without space.
Be good. We want to do good things for the people. Kind of like when we started Apple, it's like computers were only for the big, huge entities. And we said, no, let's make them available to people to improve their lives.
We're tracking about 27,000 things in space. So they're not doing the other fun things that we talk about a lot, right? Like space exploration or doing things that are science in space, like the International Space Station. But those things have traditionally not been very accessible to normal everyday people. I mean, developers in dorm rooms, space will not be sustainable if we mess up the one avenue we have as an exit. So today, Wayfinder is the only platform available that's available free, partly because of our partnership with Omega and the great work that we've been able to do together. Everything in space that's near space that's around 10 centimeters or bigger, if it's bigger than a softball, we see it, and we provide that at wayfinder.privateer.com, so you can go see all of those things. So as things are maneuvering, we're providing that as a free service, or at least a subsidized service, so we don't charge the space operators or university students putting their first satellites up. We provide that because it's the right thing to do. We don't want people crashing in space. Right? If you got on an airplane and they walked down the aisle before your flight and said, give me $5 and we probably won't hit another plane, you'd probably get off the plane. Apollo 13 was pretty instrumental in how we feel about space. And we think a lot about the vision of Omega, our own values of keeping space sustainable and accessible for humanity. Those things are very, very important. With Omega and winning the Silver Snoopy, that's very, very prestigious, and it means a lot to us that type of mechanical precision and that accuracy goes into our space tracking as well. I mean, I've got a 5-year-old daughter who, about a year ago, started telling me that she wanted to go to space. She really wants to go travel there. But she also knows how to share better than most of the people we have operating in space. We have a lot of sensors looking at the same things on Earth. If we could share those sensors, that's one of the most sustainable things you can do is share. The way that we track it is using like phased array radar from the ground or telescopes. We don't know things in general, like drag and radiation profile. So we don't know like the size, shape, material properties of every object in space. You know, as Steve said, we need consortiums, we need governments, we need companies to actually work together to provide these data openly and transparently and freely so that we don't get in more trouble.
AI can look at a lot of variables at the same time, as well as humans, and communicate it back very well. And I look at AI as a great search engine, great reporters, but you still need some intelligent humans at the top knowing what to do with it and what it means.
You know, in space, the issue is not just all the things we've been talking about, the sensing and detecting and tracking and monitoring and predicting. The timing and precision of how we operate in space is what's going to keep space safe and sustainable. In space, timing is everything.
The next big breakthrough in space will be a lot of knowledge about what's in space and what's on Earth coming from to open source to the world,